美国副总统贺锦丽、美国国会议员2月3日访问了国会大厦，向前总统特朗普的支持者上个月袭击国会大厦时遇害的国会警察布莱恩·希克尼克表示敬意。在1月6日发生骚乱的第二天，死于伤势的希克尼克的遗体被火化，一个庄严的仪式在国会大厦圆形大厅举行。美国总统拜登、国会议员和其他警察也表达了他们的敬意。希克尼克是数百名特朗普支持者冲进国会大厦的受害者。当时的特朗普总统在一次激烈的演讲中敦促他们对抗自己在选举中败给拜登。另外还有四人在骚乱事件中丧生。这一事件导致特朗普第二次被弹劾。下周他将因煽动叛乱的指控在参议院接受审判。特朗普的律师周二便称，议员弹劾前总统在法律上是不合法的。自19世纪以来，大约有36位杰出美国人的灵柩在国会大厦受到表彰，其中12人是前总统。根据希克尼克的父亲表示，在1月6日的暴力事件中，他被喷了胡椒喷雾，头部被击中。在他被紧急送往附近的医院时，救护车人员对他进行了两次心肺复苏。他于1月7日去世，但是没有对此案提起任何指控。希克尼克曾经在新泽西空军国民警卫队服役，2008年加入国会警察局。
And all you have to do is look at his picture in the memorial book, the little program here, and you could see it. What a good, kind, decent man he was. That Brian and his family.were made to pay such a high price for his devoted service in the Capitol was a senseless tragedy, one that we are still grappling with. It has left deep scars here in this building, among his friends and his colleagues, as have the tragic deaths of two of Brian's fellow officers in the day since his passing, Officer Liebengood, Officer Smith.
Each day,When members enter the Capitol, this temple of democracy, we will remember his sacrifice and then others that day who fought so hard to protect the Capitol and the Congress. And throughout our nation's history, including Officer Jacob Chestnut and Detective John Gibson, and we're blessed to be joined today by Officer Chestnut's wife, Gwendolyn. The courage of these heroes brings honor, brings luster to our Constitution. And our democracy.